Welcome to this presentation where we're going to have a look at SUSE Linux Enterprise 10 server and just the use of grep on the server. So if we have a look, our server name currently is DAOESB. If we go through and change the server name or the host name through YaST, we might want to know which files have been changed. So let's look at this. If we go into network devices and choose network card, and just step through in the normal way, enter the host name and name server, we can see we've got DAOESB spelt with the B as in bumblebee. We want to change it to DAOESB as in the letter B, and then jump through to the finish. It's a very simple matter of then changing it through on my OES server. But we want to see then what has changed. Generally, it's going to be files within the etc directory. So you can see using this command here, find from the etc directory, where the name can be anything. On each file that we find with the find command, we're going to execute the command grep, and we're going to search for DAOESB. The round brackets are then just saying, okay, well, on the file that we found, and then we end our command with a backslash and semicolon. So we're going to execute the command now, and you can see that we found the occurrence of DAOESB on several lines in configuration files. But it's showing me the found lines. It's not telling me which files they were found in. So if I do a grep minus L, it won't show me the sought after text, it will just show me the files that it was found in. So we're going to run it again, this time with grep minus L, DAOESB. And then we can find that in the etc directory, it's found it in our nds.conf, ncpserver.conf, our SSH files, the hostname, the host file, the postfix file, etc. So this can be far more useful than just displaying the text, and hopefully you found the video useful.